Thought is the only thing over which you have absolute control, yet unless you are the proverbial exception, which is about 1 out of every 10,000, you permit other people to enter the sacred mansion of your mind, and there deposit through suggestion their troubles and woes, adversities and falsehoods, just as though you did not have the power to close the door and keep them out. You have within your control the power to select the material that constitutes the dominating thoughts of your mind. And just as surely as you are reading these lines, those thoughts which dominate your mind will bring you success or failure according to their nature. The fact that thought is the only thing over which you have absolute control is within itself of most profound significance, as it strongly suggests that thought is your nearest approach to divinity on this earthly plane. This fact also carries another highly impressive suggestion, namely, that thought is your most important tool, the one with which you may shape your worldly destiny according to your own liking. Surely divine providence did not make thought the sole power over which you have absolute control, without associating with that power potentialities which, if understood and developed, would stagger the imagination. Self-control is solely a matter of thought control. Please read the foregoing sentence aloud. Read it thoughtfully and meditate over it before reading further, because it is without doubt the most important single sentence of this entire course. A student in one of my classes once asked how one went about controlling one's thoughts when in a state of intense anger, and I replied, in exactly the same way that you would change your manner and the tone of your voice if you were in a heated argument with a member of your family and heard the doorbell ring, warning you that company was about to visit you. You would control yourself because you would desire to do so. If you have ever been in a similar predicament, where you found it necessary to cover up your real feelings and change the expression on your face quickly, you know how easily it can be done, and you also know that it can be done because one wants to do it. Back of all achievement, back of all self-control, back of all thought control, is that magic something called desire. It is no misstatement of fact to say that you are limited only by the depth of your desires. When your desires are strong enough, you will appear to possess superhuman powers to achieve. No one has ever explained this strange phenomenon of the mind, and perhaps no one ever will explain it. But if you doubt that it exists, you have but to experiment and be convinced.